my first string for my centripetal force board. Ooh. Mr. C, WunderSTEM Hotline, how may I help you? Oh, hi. Yes. Oh, that's awesome. You're building a computer. Custom parts? Yeah, I know exactly where you can make some custom parts. Yep. I'll make a video and I'll send it to you. I'll post it online. All right, bye. That was Josh, and he was wondering, where can he make some custom parts for his custom computer? Well, I have the perfect friend. She is Cara, the Innovation and Makerspace Manager at the Greene County Public Library. She has all sorts of cool tools that allow us to make stuff with our fingers and our brains. Yeah, it's so cool. We should go check it out, don't you think? All right, let's go check out Cara and all the amazing things she has at Spark Place.
My name is Cara Kouse. I am the Innovation and Makerspace Manager here at Greene County Public Library. A makerspace can look a lot of different ways, but the core of a makerspace is it's a place where you can go and you can make things, you can create. You can learn different skills, and you know, we may have different equipment in different kinds of makerspaces, but at the end of the day, a makerspace is a place where you go and you create something that didn't exist before. The makerspace is great for all ages and for anybody. And it's important, I think, for it to be in a public library because it really is another form of literacy. So just as people come to the library to access information, in the makerspace they can access digital information and equipment that is becoming ever more prevalent in society, but that you don't really have an access point for. You know, you see about 3D printing on, you know, the news now because people are doing all kinds of things with 3D printing. It's in medicine, it's in construction, but where do you go to actually learn how to use a 3D printer if you're no longer in school? So that's the beauty of having it in the library where it's publicly accessible. People can come in and learn all kinds of different design and equipment. And it's just great because I really believe that, you know, anybody can come in and use the makerspace, and it doesn't matter if you're 3 or 97. It doesn't matter if it's a kid who's gifted or a kid who has developmental disabilities. The great thing about the makerspace is we meet you where you are and then teach you to do what you want to do. So it doesn't matter what you know coming in the door, we meet you where you are and help you get your project to fruition. And everybody is always just so excited when they get to walk out with something that they made with their own hands while here in the space. Inherently, as you're designing something new, you're going to have failures along the way, and that's how you learn. And having a safe space to feel like failure isn't a bad thing, I think, is really important just in general. So for people to be able to come in and learn that, okay, I tried this thing, it didn't work, but here's what I learned, and here's how I'm going to do it now to make it work better, is just a huge, you know, thing. And I think it's a huge piece of just learning that whole design thinking, building process. And I think that it helps too, just going forward in other parts of your life to say, okay, that didn't go so well, no matter what it is you're doing, but that's okay. I'll learn from that and I'll pick up and try something different. I'd say the laser is my favorite just because it's very versatile. If you can come up with it, you can pretty much figure out a way to do it on the laser.
Okay, so we put the material in the laser and then we focus it. So I focus to make sure that it's at the right height for the laser to cut through. And now I'm setting up the speed, the power, and the frequency of the laser to the right settings for this material. This board is a little bit warped, so I'm gonna go a little slower just to make sure we cut through it. And that should be everything. So we're gonna hit print and it's going to send it over here. See if I cut through first.
Oh, that's so cool.
And you must have it on this board, technically.
Oh, that cuts so well.
It's very clean. And this is a fairly warped piece of wood. I selected it because people aren't going to pick it when they're buying it from me because it's warped.
Yeah, but.
But this, if you get your settings right, it doesn't matter.
This right here. I actually like this part better.
Yeah.
We just made that.
Yeah.
Isn't that so cool?
That's why I love the laser.
Another piece of equipment that gets a lot of use are the 3D printers. The 3D printers are really kind of fun because people come in, it's an easy, I think, access point because people have heard of 3D printers. So they come in and they know that there are files they can download and print. But we also try to teach people to use even very simple CAD programs to design their own things. And kids love coming in and designing, you know, their own keychains or toys or putting their name on something and then 3D printing it in plastic. And then we have a lot of people who are coming in with, they have something old that has a broken part that they can no longer get a part for. So they're using 3D scanning and CAD design to recreate those parts and to print them on the 3D printers. Yeah, so the sound booth also gets a lot of use, and we've been interested to see how that's even morphed over time, that, you know, a lot of people come in because they like doing their music in the sound room. But we also see, like, we had a grandma come in and she did some sound recording of reading a book to her grandkids to send them that sound bite in the book as a gift, which was really cool. We also see people come in to record podcasts or commercials. But over the course of the pandemic, it was interesting because we saw more and more kids who had to record something as part of like a final project to submit for school because they weren't in class in person. So they realized that they could come in and use the sound booth to record these projects for school, which was really cool to watch too.
So we're actually in the sound booth, and this space right here is where I recorded triangles. That's right, I brought in my mic and I had this all set up and I was working on my project right here. So it just sounds so incredible. And I can't get this at home. So when I want to make a song, I want to record something, this is the place to come. And it's all free. Just another really cool piece if you're into STEM. But more importantly, if you're creative and you want to do some artsy stuff also, this is where it's at. All sides are equal. So perfectly created,
it should be illegal when you check it out. So we have a lot of people that enjoy making mugs or shirts because that's something that people really like making, and then you can wear, you know, the design that you made yourself, which is really fun, especially for kids, I think, and adults.
Oh, I love being crafty. Here's my logo. I'm gonna get this laid down nice and smooth. I wanna center my logo with this tool. And once the logo is centered, we're going to add some Teflon to keep everything safe and prevent it from burning. And we're going to press for 15 seconds at 325 degrees Fahrenheit. When it's ready, remove that Teflon, peel back that logo, and whoa, look at that.
WunderSTEM.
On the vinyl printer cutters, we see a lot of different uses. We see everything from small businesses that are coming in to print decals for their trucks and trailers, for signage for their businesses. We see people coming in to print stickers to hand out to promote whatever their cause is at fairs and festivals. We see a lot of banners printed. Banners are printed for everything from, you know, rotary groups to people who are showing animals at the fair, again, to small businesses or people who are in parades. We've already got media width. So right now this is the size. It's doing it all in one big sheet.
Can we flip it horizontally?
If you hit the circular thing there and then just say print, it'll rip it and then print it.
Awesome, that was too easy.
That's really awesome.
Oh, look at this.
You feel the backing?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Makes it much easier.
Let's put it up here. It's official. We got our WunderSTEM logo.
So we also have a lot of software available in this space to support the use of all the equipment, because for pretty much all of the equipment in the space, you have to start with those digital files. And, you know, whether you're creating them or editing something that already exists, you need that access. So we do have people that come in sometimes just to use the software that don't even necessarily want to use the equipment today, but they want to come in and work on designs. So we have, you know, from Corel to Adobe, we have a lot of different software that is all free to come in and use anytime with your Greene County Public Library card. When I was a kid, I was always the kid that was fixing other kids' toys and figuring out how to, you know, take things apart, figuring out how they worked, putting them back together to work better or to work again if they were broken. So I always kind of liked that. I went to school. I got my bachelor's degrees in applied mathematics and computer science because, again, I like math and how things work. But I'd always worked in libraries, and I really liked, you know, helping people and helping people find the information they were looking for. So working in libraries was something I'd always done. So I ended up getting my master's in library science, and then I went on to manage branch libraries. But I always thought it was really interesting where libraries and technology intersected, because libraries were one of the first institutions to digitize records and to have online catalogs, and watching kind of that progression was interesting. So when I saw that places were starting to look at how libraries and makerspaces were meeting up and STEM programming in libraries, I got really excited because that was like everything I like to do all in one thing. So it was really, really awesome to be able to get to come in and build a makerspace in a library, because it was like the dream job that I always wanted that didn't exist. So getting to kind of build my own makerspace in a library and combine all of those things, that freedom of access, that learning component for the community, and just being able to do all of that while still getting to work with really cool equipment and technology was really fun for me. So if I were to tell, you know, my 10-year-old self something about, you know, my job now, it would really be not to worry about dreaming within any confines, that just because the job you want to do doesn't exist, that shouldn't stop you, that just because you're interested in something that may not be readily available or that you see the path that you need to take to get there, to just keep working, and that eventually, you know, you're going to find this amazing job that you enjoy going to every day, and it's just really fun and combines all of those things that you enjoy doing, and you still get to help people while working with cool equipment. So it's a lot of fun.
What an amazing career, and what an amazing space. Libraries are already such cool places with all of the books and all of the stuff that you can check out. Movies, DVDs, all the cool stuff. But now they even have a space where you can go make stuff? Cara is awesome. She has a great job and it's so much fun. She made a space for people to go make more stuff. I mean, how cool is that? And I got to make a t-shirt. Check this out. My WunderSTEM t-shirt. That's right. I got my swag. Not only did I get to make some t-shirts, but I got to make stickers. And I've been making these centripetal force boards. One of the coolest things I got to make there was this. This is my Newton's cradle. Check this out. And it works. Have you ever wondered if you can make something like this yourself? You have to check out your nearest makerspace. It's so much fun. It's so awesome. But wait.
Wait.
I'm wondering, will you join us for the next episode of WunderSTEM? See ya.